Hi everybody, this is Patty, and I have to tell you, I had some problems with my recorder, and I'm going to have to do a voiceover for the cover. So I am so sorry about that, but those things happen, and I'm beginning to get things figured out, so bear with me. I took the plane, and you're going to see my hands move all the over the place because I was talking to you while I was doing this. I was trying to decide what to do with this cover because I didn't like just the plain cream canvas. So I first used the distress paint in Victorian velvet and it was just too pink. So then I went over it with Tattered Angels chalkboard glimmer mist in Valencia, which helped a little. And I ended up going over with the plain Jane Simply Sheer matte mist watercolor in soft peach. That's also a Tattered Angels product. And I like the end outcome of that. I took these three stickers and I put two coats of, or two layers of the black cardstock on it. And I used the Eileen's Mod Podge, a couple of coats on front and back. This is going to be my strap to hold it closed. It has a couple magnets underneath there. And those are the small basic gray magnets. And you can see here, this is my tab that's going to go on the front. And I used one of the tin roof caps that we've used all along. And I just cut it down to fit in underneath that square. There they are there. And I just cut it into a small rectangle so it would fit between, sandwich between the two pieces of black. So I've marked on the back approximately where I want it. And I have some white score tape there. And I'm going to put it down because that's all going to be covered up. It's really not going to hold it close, but it's going to give it just a pretty illusion, which is what I kind of like. Can you tell I talk with my hands? My sister-in-law has always told me if I sat on my hands, I wouldn't be able to talk. So here is the mats. Each side, front, back, and spine is going to be covered with a black mat. This is the back of the August. And then I have this little cutout, and you're going to see I forget something here, and that's just typical Patty. You know how I am. Things have not changed. Even though I have a new craft room, things have not changed. And I wanted this spot so that I could put a to and from, or if somebody buys this, they could put a to and from, or if I gift it or whatever. I'm going to use Eileen's Tacky Glue on this. And I did spray a little bit of water in here and to try to smooth it out a little bit. And I'm going to put it down. And you know, the reason I wanted the tacky glue is just for that reason right there. It gives you a little bit of wiggle room so that you can move things around if it's not quite in the right place. And that's what I wanted. Now you may not have the same leftover pieces that I have. And let me give you one super duper piece of advice. Please, please don't do as I do, do as I say. And I'm saying when you start a project, pick out what you want for the outside first. Put it aside, put it away, put it back so you don't cut into it. I am notorious for jumping in and starting something and then realizing, uh-oh, now what am I going to do with the cover? And that's kind of what happened here. I was so busy making pages that I hadn't sat anything back. So I had to do a little thinking about what I was going to do. But I like the outcome. And I want you, I have had one person already, and I'm sorry your name slips my mind, but I will be posting it under this video. Someone that sent me some pictures of what they did with the album. So I would like you to send me pictures, links to your blog, links to your videos, whatever, so that we can have a community here of this mini so others can get inspiration from it. You can see I've just cut out pieces from the stickers because I had quite a few stickers left. I backed everything on the black cardstock. And as you can see, do you notice what I've done wrong here? If you haven't, just wait, it's coming soon. And I put, of course, the glue on here so it will hold really good. And that's just one of the cutout pieces of the 12 by 12 paper. And I just snipped around it and added the black cardstock to it to make it a little bit sturdier. Okay, now we're going to move right along to the spine as soon as I get that adhered down really tight. And that's the thing. You want to go back and check stuff. I have this little rose thing that I'm going to put up in the corner. That's just another little piece I cut out from the paper. I thought about using this lace my niece had given me, and I just couldn't get it where I liked it. See, I really like the color of this now, and you don't have to use those colors. Use whatever you have. Maybe you want to pick up the blues or the yellows or the greens or whatever, or maybe you like the ecru color, the camel color of the canvas. I just wanted something a little bit more colored. And because I did it after the book was done, I just laid sheets like my mat there on the inside so that I wouldn't spray anything on my finished pages. And now I have this blue mat that I'm putting in here. And that's just, you can see the back of the cardstock there. And then I have three of the stamps. And I corner rounded everything. Some are corner rounded with the half inch, some with a quarter inch. And I did not give you dimensions for any of this because I want you to use what you have on hand. Your dimensions may be different than mine. I cornered the edges. You may want to leave your square like the book is. Whatever you want to do, as always, as we've done with the whole book, there are no rights and wrongs. It's whatever appeals to you and what looks good for you. And now I have these two little, oops. See, I have that, my glue upside down in a little container with some paper towels with water, and it soaked the water up. That's why every once in a while you see a little bit of water come out. I have these half-backed pearls, the black ones. They came from Saw Crafters, but I'm sure you can find half the flat pearls that are just a half pearl. I like using those because they stay on so much better. Now I've got another piece of the black cardstock. This is the American Crafts, the textured one. And I like it when it's just going to be a mat and not folded because it's got a little bit of texture and it's a little bit heavier. And see, we just have a smidgen of the back of the book showing, but I like that contrast of that peachy pink popping out there. And I think it ended up matching really well. And here's this brown. I was really surprised. I had so few larger pieces left that when I went back hunting, I was surprised at how well I liked this brown pattern. It just was the complementary to go with the other that really made it pop. Another mat. And I ended up putting the black behind each one just because I think it really is eye appealing. It pops to you. Now, this is when I realized, uh-oh, wait a minute. The oops moment. See, I had a piece there that I had cut. Now I am carefully peeling it off. And as you'll see what happened to the black? But it won't matter. And they need that blue back there because you need the blue to make it pop there. I'm just making sure now that I have the right one in the right spot because now I'm paranoid. But I really like it. But we'll cover that other up in just a second and you'll see that it won't matter. Even though I use the glue, I'm going to put some more glue all around there. And then I'm just going to go over that goobery spot right there. Nobody will ever, ever know that I've done this. And I've told you many, many times when you make mistakes, we are the ones that know, other people don't. So it is no big deal. Don't worry about it. It's just great if you make goobers too. And I hope you do. I hope I'm not the only one that does it. I'm using ATG gun here because this is paper to paper. I don't need the strength like I need with the black to the top of the book. I had two of these journal cards and I cut out the frame of the top one and added the foam tape just so it will pop and look like a frame. I kind of like that illusion there. I'm so sorry that I have my head in the camera. This is all a new setup for me in the craft room, so I'm still learning and it's going to take a while till I get the process down good. Now I have a black mat to make it pop and I just love how it looks. Now there's where my band is going to go and I'm just making sure I have it in the right spot because I don't want to chop off the little girl or boy's heads. So I'm going to put it down again with the ATG because that's plenty strong enough for what this is. It's not going to get any wear and tear. It's just for pretty. And then I have this, and as you can see, I have three layers of foam tape there. That's because I have so many layers that I want to make it kind of even, and I've only put it on the one side. I did go back off camera and put one small strip across the bottom so that my band kind of loops into that now. I have these arrows that I cut out eons ago, so I traced one on chipboard, and I took out some of the paper there and cut it out. You can see, and I use 3D crystal lacquer on it. And then I attached the spring, summer, autumn, winter on it because that's what the book hole is. It's the whole year of pictures. And I thought that was kind of a neat idea. I have gotten off camera just a little bit here. And again, I apologize. It's going to take me a while to figure out my setup. I'll probably still be saying this a year from now. You know how I am. But I'll pull it down. I'll realize it in just a minute and pull it down. And then I have these greatest moments. This is a little piece of, oh, you can't see it. There she is. This is a little piece of wood. There we go. And I put that there. I end up taking the little yellow girl out. And if you look at the picture in the front and the pictures to follow, you'll see. Because I didn't like her. She just was too annoying to me. I'll use her on a card or something else, but she's not good for the front cover. And you'll see if you go back and look at that first picture or the ones to follow, you'll see I used just a little girl with a spray that I cut out from the paper and slid it under the arrow and under the greatest memories. And I really, really like the look of it. So it's just a matter of playing until you get what you like and what is appealing to you. That's the whole key to the whole thing. I didn't want a bunch of flowers on this, and I didn't want a whole bunch of bling on it. I wanted to primarily use more of the paper because I know that's what you have there too, and perhaps that will give you some ideas. I do have this little girl. Isn't she precious? I put two tiny pearls on the bow on her waist and the one in her hair. And I am going to put some foam tape at the bottom because again, we have layers here that I'm trying to make it even Steven. So I'm going to pop dot her legs or foam tape her legs. And I ended up realizing I had enough room for another little skinny piece there. You just kind of have to cut it out a little bit where her dress part is so it kind of fits in and around. And that's the whole thing, just playing with it until you get it like how you like it. But now the top part will go flush, and then the bottom part will pop out to make her stand even. And I want to make sure she's behind or underneath the band because I don't want her interfering with the band. And that's basically the whole outside of the book. I hope you have enjoyed this series. I'm sorry I left you in the lurch, but that happens sometimes in real life. I will be posting more videos. I think I will do a walkthrough of the whole book from start to finish. So those that do not want to see each page can just see the book in its entirety. Thank you so much for joining me, watching me. Please subscribe. Comment and hit the like button. So appreciate all of you, and be sure and send me the links to your finished outside covers. Bye, everyone. Have a very crafty day.